Rocket Richard was unlike anything who had ever come along in the NHL. He was tested everywhere he went. He was booed, he was heckled. He ultimately became a symbol for French Canadians.
Being from Quebec, you can imagine Maurice was the name that we heard. I couldn't watch him, but I could hear it on the radio.
It was Maurice Richard, 22 years old and the idol of Montreal, who banged it in his second goal.
Books have been written, university theses have been done on the Rocket, on the importance of him. And all through it, Rocket just tried to maintain, I'm just a hockey player, which was ridiculous because he was never just that.
The legend of Maurice the Rocket Richard has bonded generations of Quebecers. A symbol of pride among Canadian Francophones, few could ever match the Rocket's determination and goal-scoring acumen.
There was fire in his eyes every time he got the puck.
As soon as he got the puck at the red line and he focused on the net, you knew that no one was going to get the puck off him.
Wait now for Canadians with Locke and Richard.
In just his second year, Richard teamed with Toe Blake and Elmer Locke to create the Punchline, an offensive juggernaut for five seasons.
The pass for Richard, he cuts in from the side. He stops, he shoots, he scores!
I never had to look for Rocket. I knew where he was. And the more we played it, the more it fell together.
Together, they broke scoring records, won two Stanley Cups, and helped Richard become the first player to tally 50 goals in a season.
Nobody was more possessed to score.
When he came over the blue line, he was going to get a shot on net, whether he was on his knees, on his backside, or on his elbows.
He was the most explosive player of his time. He was explosive temperamentally.
He's miserable when he's on ice.
The Rocket's temper got the best of him on March 13, 1955, when he struck a linesman during an altercation in Boston. NHL President Clarence Campbell suspended Richard for the remainder of the season and the Stanley Cup playoffs.
I don't think anybody in English Canada can imagine what the Rocket meant to fans in Montreal. And when he was suspended by President Clarence Campbell, that triggered the riot outside the forum that you wouldn't see in any other sport, in any other city.
On March 17th, with protests erupting outside of the Montreal forum, both Campbell and Richard attended the Canadiens game against the Detroit Red Wings.
You can tell there's an ugliness in the building. Someone sets off a tear gas bomb. The building is evacuated by the fire marshal. The Montreal Canadiens forfeit the game, and the building is cleared. By this point, the violence has spilled out into the streets of Montreal. The Rocket finally had to go before a battery of microphones and plead for public peace.
Without the Rocket, Montreal lost to Detroit in the Stanley Cup final. He returned the following season when he was joined on a line by his younger brother, Henri. Together, they won five straight Stanley Cups, champions every year until Maurice's retirement in 1960. In addition to eight championships, the Rocket won a Hart Trophy and was the first player to net 500 career goals. He set playoff goal-scoring records and was a 14-time All-Star. But above all, he remained the face of hockey in Quebec, receiving ovations every time he stepped onto the Forum ice. None bigger than the night they closed the building on March 11th, 1996.
I think there would still be applauding. For the people that saw Rocket Richard, especially for the French Canadian, he was their hero. He was their hero.
I was in that building, the Forum, when Boom Boom would score, and Béliveau would score, and Dickie Moore would score. But when Rocket scored, I swear that the cheer was just a little louder.